দর্শক মন্ডলী, ওয়েলকাম ব্যাক টু আওয়ার শো পলিটিক্স অ্যান্ড বিয়ন্ড। আমাদের শেষ সেগমেন্টে আসি। অবশ্য আমাদের মাঝখানে একটা ব্রেক হবে আজানের জন্য। আমরা শেষ সেগমেন্টে এখন আমরা আলাপ করব দি ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স অফ দ্য রেফারেন্ডাম ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স অফ স্কটল্যান্ড। আপনারা জানেন যে স্কটল্যান্ড ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স হয়ে যেতে চাচ্ছে এবং তারা রেফারেন্ডাম দিয়েছে, এবং সেটা আমাদের ইংল্যান্ডের উপরে এবং ছোটোখাটো বড়ো উপরে কীভাবে এফেক্ট হবে এবং এটা কি আদৌ ভালো কি না সেটা আমরা আলাপ করব। যেহেতু আর মাত্র 6 সপ্তাহ আছে রেফারেন্ডাম, আই থিঙ্ক ইটস অন দ্য 18th of September, সেজন্য আমরা এই 6 সপ্তাহ আমরা একটা না একটা সেগমেন্টে আমরা স্কটল্যান্ড সম্বন্ধে আলাপ করব। আমি এগেইন আল স্টার্ট উইথ ইউ এগেন উমেশ, your mayor, he's a Scot.
Yes, very good, sir.
Is he voting yes or no?
You'll have to ask him that. No, he wants to, obviously, he wants Scotland to remain part of the United Kingdom.
Part of it. He said it publicly. Because he's a Scotsman and he's running an English borough.
Well, because we are one United Kingdom.
Exactly, yeah. So if he's going to vote now.
My parents of India, I was born in Africa, yeah. And I came here just part of the movement of the diaspora, sure. through the days of empire.
It will be.
That is what makes this country such a great country. Our diversity, we can all work together, we can live together, enjoy life together and meet challenges together.
It's not only him. I mean, if you look at the maximum MPs in the parliament, I think more than 60% are Scots. You've got Jim Fitzpatrick, you have got George Galloway. I think there are numbers of them. Then you've got the our shadow defense secretary, what's his name, I forgot, he's a Scotsman.
So Jim Murphy.
Murphy.
Well, there are very many good Scottish MPs like Jim Fitzpatrick, and some maybe not so good Scottish origin MPs like, dare I say, Mr. Galloway.
Okay, that's your opinion.
That's my opinion. I'm sure people disagree with me.
I know. So do you think it's a good thing for Scotland?
Well, first of all, Scottish people will take the decision. But in my opinion, I mean, it would be better if they're united. One is one, two is 11.
Sure. I mean, the other day I had a question from a friend saying that if Scotland goes this time, then Cameron is not going to win his seat. Does it really affect it? Because if you remember, back in when Tony Blair was around, he had to hand over, I think, was it Taiwan, to back with China, and Robin Cook was the governor there, and Prince Charles went and hand over the
Hong Kong.
He hand over the flag and said the greatest Chinese takeaway. That was his remarks, Charles's remark. I mean, since England was ruling the whole world, it's gradually became smaller and smaller.
Smaller, yeah.
Isn't it? The sun doesn't is now setting on England. So do you think that even if Scotland goes, what's next then? Is it Wales? Is it Ireland? There's a domino effect, isn't it?
There's certainly the rise of what commentators are called English nationalism, the feeling in the regions, Scotland's getting all this attention, and the North should get, have its own sort of assembly. And we've had these debates before in the 80s and in the 90s, when John Prescott was around in charge of these things, assembly for the Southwest. But we've had the Welsh Assembly, we've had the Scottish Parliament. And my view is this is obviously a matter for the people of Scotland to decide. And let us not forget, there's a very sizable Scottish Asian origin community as well.
Of course,
I suppose the other day, one of our councillors, his wife has got family who run restaurants in the Shetland Islands. Yeah. And one has said that, this was only last week I found out.
Sure.
There are emotional sort of issues, there are cultural issues, there are what defines a nation. So this is a very complex argument that has always been there in history, and the issue will arise in the decades to come. But if you look at it from economic viewpoint, Scotland's a small country, about 8 million people. It's small in terms of population, and it's got a proud history and heritage. Yeah. Two-thirds of Scotland's trade is with the rest of the United Kingdom. Yeah. Whereas the other way around is only 6%.
Sure.
So there's a bigger economic picture here that I think Scottish people who enter voting referendum will take into account. We're also living in a globalized world where nations are now dependent on one another. And people are looking at forming federations, economic federations.
Sure.
One of the things I always said about the Indian subcontinent, where there have been many wars in the past, how India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, the Himalayan kingdoms can all actually come together to share waters, to form a common sort of economic block. Scotland accounts for 8% of the, of the UK's population. It actually benefits quite generously from what is called the Barnett formula, where central government gives out grants to local authorities. Mm-hmm. This was in 1978. So actually, you know, there are economic benefits to the Scottish people in terms of remaining in the United Kingdom. And there's also an alternative argument being put forward that instead of having full independence, there is what you call DO Max.
That's it. I think that's what Neil Campbell and powers. Clegg and the others are interested in.
But to finish off on this note, the SNP and Salman go on about the North Sea oil reserves. Now these reserves, you know, are running out. And let us also not forget, you know, this has helped us all, not just people in Scotland, but when we had the great economic crash. Sure. 5 years ago, the Royal Bank of Scotland, the Bank of Scotland, who bailed them those banks out,
sure,
which is the United
sure.
Kingdom government. Yeah. So together, we are stronger, we are better, and nationalism of the right type. You know, of course, you know, people in Scotland are proud of to be Scottish, quite rightly so, and you know, I'm proud of my origins, but I also want to be part of a wider world where we can all work together, where you know, a lot of boundaries have been drawn up and so on. So I think a United Kingdom, but a reformed United Kingdom. You know, power in the real sense being devolved to different communities, whilst having a strong parliament, you know, in terms of foreign policy, in terms of defense policy, United Kingdom can carry much more weight, in terms of economic policy as well, in the wider world than Wales, Scotland, England, all going off on their own.
Sure, sure. I mean, do you think that it's one man's ego that taking part of the nation into a jeopardy? You know, Alex Salmond and his one-man ego. He wants to be this Wallace of Scotland, but I'm the one who got this independence. You know,
I don't think so. But all problems start from the you know little things. You know.
Yeah, that's of course.
Yeah, and
but at the end of the day, they are a nationalist party.
Exactly.
Just like BNP in England.
Well, nationalism, as Umeshwari said, nationalism, right nationalism, is not a bad thing.
Yeah. So.
We are all proud of our history, our background, our root, but on common grounds we can be united. And there are quite a few nations in the earth, they are fighting unitedly for the development in a positive sense. So if United Kingdom is united, they will have bigger economy, bigger workforce, bigger GDP. And I think the UK, United Kingdom would be better off if they were united. Instead of you know being,
it's always good to stay together. It's always good to stay together.
And Scotland has a lot to gain.
Just to clarify, দর্শকদের জন্য আমরা হঠাৎ করে ব্রেকে চলে যাব আজানের জন্য আমরা কথা বলার মাঝে হঠাৎ করে আমরা চলে যাব তারপর আবার আমরা চলে আসব. So please do not mind of that. জি বলেন.
Scotland has a lot to gain. I mean, from the United Kingdom, as during severe financial crisis. I mean, if, for example, Scotland was independent at that time, they could have been like Greece or other countries if English bank did not go to rescue. So I think probably Scotland would be better off if they were deciding to be part of UK.
On that note, hold that note, we're going to go for the azan and then we're going to come back straight away. Shridharshukla, I'm Rajana Chilajachi. Welcome back to our show. Amra kotha bolchilam Scotland shomonde. Najib bhai, you were saying about Scotland and the separation, and it's always good to stay together. Amar ekta point of view is one of my point of view is that who's going to be the winner out of this? And I think you might disagree with me. There'll be two winners in this. One is Alex Salmond. He's going to put his name on all the prominent histories, like with Mahatma Gandhi and the others. And the other one that's going to be a winner in the long run, in future, is the EU. Because Scotland will then join in 10 years' time with EU. EU will then start getting contributions. As a nation, you'll have to contribute, and you will have another seat. Do you not agree with this?
Partly.
What is your take on this, Umesh?
Well, I was reading an article the other day that Alex Salmond may not want to win this this particular referendum because the time is not ready and so on.
Yeah.
And it is a way of him getting more concessions from the Westminster government. So if he gets a good enough result to make another go in two or three, down the line, he can claim both victory and at the same time, give the impression that he's not lost because he's got all these concessions.
Sure, sure. I mean, what would be the best scenario if you were Alex Salmond? What would you do? Would you go for the independence and go for a referendum, or would you ask for more power from Westminster, more financial power?
That is a hypothetical question, but if I was on that scenario, of course, I mean, I would have used as a bargaining tool to be given more power, more resources, and probably time is not the right time, probably lingering for another decade and then probably.
Sure.
Well, I think one of the things is that when
what would you would have done if you were Alex Salmond?
All right. Well, one of the things about Alex Salmond was when you win an election with such a large majority that you weren't expecting, because the SNP actually trailing behind Labour in the polls. Let us not forget that. I was actually in Scotland for a few days at the time. And the SNP went on to win a victory beyond their wildest dreams. And they ended up with all these members of the Scottish Parliament. And as this article said, Alex Salmond probably didn't recognize some of them because he wasn't expecting them to win. So I think he's a very astute politician. He wouldn't be very easy if he wasn't. They did promise a referendum, and he's got the timing the way he wanted it now. And I think in some ways, if he gets a good enough result that is credible, but not win, as I said earlier, that he can say, look, I'm delivering all these concessions for you. And still present it as a victory. And I think my guess is that is probably what he would want.
Sometimes, politicians' mind cannot be read. I mean, they might have something in the mind and probably that's not reflective what they say.
Sure.
And there's a saying that, I mean, politicians tend to promise to build up a bridge where there is no river.
I mean, there are many scenarios to a fully independent country.
Sure.
You know, where is your army? What currency are you going to have?
Yeah.
You know,
they want to keep the pound. That's what they were saying.
Well,
Osborne saying you can't keep it.
European countries, and studies have been done about this that are comparable to Scotland in terms of size, population. They actually have had their own currency for many years. Mm. So there are all these deep, very deep fundamental issues.
And they're not talking about one of the crucial things that the BME community would want to hear about the immigration. I mean, neither Alex or his deputy is talking about the immigration, what they're going to do. Are they going to give an amnesty right after the independence?
And,
or are they going to,
It requires a very serious answer just to sort of blame the BBC for for UK winning a seat in Scotland to the European Parliament is clearly ludicrous. It's not a rational argument at all.
In terms of local economy and Scotland, I mean, I don't see there's much to say in it. But do you think that there will be some slight effect from it? I mean, would the steel price go up because they're manufacturing most of the stuff? I mean, I know Portsmouth will be one of the gainers because Cameron and Osborne both said that they will bring their ship constructions and all that into Portsmouth, and so Scotland will lose that contract, and obviously British brand goes down well in a very good way. Do you think that local boroughs like Tarhamlis, Newham and boroughs, they will be affected as much?
I think there are no winners or losers in a situation like this if England and Scotland go their separate ways. If there are any winners, they're winners in the short term, and everyone's going to lose in the long term.
Sure.
As I said, I've been through the economic arguments earlier.
Sure.
Scotland relies very heavily on trade with the rest of the United Kingdom, 2/3 of its trade. Scotland has a population of 8 million. There are more people, although there's migration into Scotland from all over the world for various reasons.
I think if they become independent,
there are more Scottish people actually coming to work or live in England,
within England
and Wales and other parts. So I think our countries, the four countries, certainly Wales, Scotland, Ireland, are historically linked, are interlocked, the economy, the culture, the language, of course.
Sure. What would you say? We've got literally less than a minute. What would you say to the Scotland's BME community? What would be your message? You might as well say.
Well, it's obviously your word. You live in Scotland, and you experience life there, and it's a society that, first, I would say, that we've got to play, an active part in. But do stay with us. Let us be one big United Kingdom family. It's to your benefit.
What would be your message, Nazir Bhai, to the Bengali community
in Scotland? I would like to say that emotion is one thing, and nationalism is one thing, and practicality is another thing. Probably Scotland is not practically ready to be independent now.
Sure.
But if really become independent, then probably from Scotland flight will come to the independent country in New Home.
Shri Dashakondli, apnara shunlen amader ajker debate ebong discussion ebong apnara quite rightly shunlen everybody wants to stay in together ebong Scotland bashi apnara jara dekhtechen ei program ta apnara jodi amader program e aste chan Scotland shomonde, please do get in touch with us.